this entire BDMP budget cycle that we've run in three cycles, we've had close to a lakh, 1 lakh submissions of citizen budget from citizens. And over 75,000 citizens have actually engaged. In addition, we also had a manifesto campaign in which we had about 26,000 citizens who provided inputs for political manifesto during the earlier election. But see, the thing is, because the BBMP budget preparation is not really looking at street level requirements, at area level requirements, at neighborhood level requirements, they are not collating all this to add it up to a city level budget, right? So even though the citizens have given this many inputs, they are all very specific, because I live in my street. I am telling you, I want street lights fixed here, or I need this park to be repaired, or we don't have roads, or we need water lines, or I need a bus stop to be, you know, repaired. But that doesn't feed into the BBMP budget. So unfortunately, though, we did a match a couple of years back, and there was about 22% overlap between what they were doing and what was asked by citizens. That's not the best way for us to analyze that. And that took a really a long time. Right. Ideally, they should take this and then roll it up into the budget. And that would be the best way in which this can happen.
Absolutely. Yeah, great. Okay, if you want to summarize the whole, you know, BBMP budget exercise or the process, so how will you paraphrase it, maybe in one or two sentences?
So I would say we should get BBMP under the KMABR rules first off, because that would provide the foundational, the policy level foundation for them to actually be accountable, right, on budget planning and management. We should get the ward committee implementation actually going in full spirit and action, which includes bottom-up budgeting and monitoring of works that are in the pipeline after the budget has been approved. The way to do this, the only way we can push for transparency and citizen engagement. Government will not be able to do this on its own. That you need to have citizens engaged continually in a transparent and fair process.
Okay, got it. Thank you, Sapna. And I would now open the panel for some question on, you know, and answers by you. So, friends, anybody, any questions?
So, Sapna, this is Ram here. A broad question. Two or three questions I have, I'll ask one by one later. One of this is, how much money comes into the thing, and how much of it gets really spent? How much is spent productively? How much is not spent productively? That is question number one. And I'll ask the other one after you answer this.
Sure. So, you know, from we have actually been trying to collate data from, let's say, the last 5 or 6 years. The variance of the BBMP budget, which means what they budget and what they actually spent, was about 63% in 2013-14. Up until 2018, it came down to about 19%. Now, one of the reasons, and when I say budget variance, I mean what did they actually say they will spend and what did they finally close their books of accounts, you know, by the end of the year, right? Now, what is happening is they're also releasing revised estimates just before they release the new budgets. So the revised estimates are very close to the actuals. So in some sense, when you look at it that way, it looks like they've actually achieved most of their budgets because the estimates have been revised. So for this, for example, this year, the last fiscal that has just gone by, we have 11,649 crore budget. The BBMP should be giving out a revised estimate tomorrow and the new budget. And based on that, we will be able to see how much of it they have actually achieved in terms of budget, you know, actuals.
Yeah, if in your view, you're assuming you were there. Sorry?
Ram has not finished, Srikanth.
Just 1 minute. Yeah, sorry, Srikanth. Now, if I continue, in your assuming you are the commissioner and you have a free hand by doing the Bangalore work, how much is required to do the kind of work? Not in 1 year, at least 3 years on a yearly basis.
See, there is some data that we had put across at some point before, and there's also a McKinsey report on the kind of infrastructure expenses required across the country, right, in the next 20 to 30 years. It runs in trillions of crores. In Bangalore itself, for the next 5 to 7 years, we will need at least a 200,000 crore budget to really up our complete infrastructure, you know, to the levels that are that meet quality standards in the next few years.
Mostly the
I just wanted to add, but this also means that there could be infrastructure that we have today which has to be upgraded to current level, current standards, and there will be new infrastructure that has to be built. So taking both into account, there is a significant spend that will have to kick in the next decade or so for us to really move the needle on the on infrastructure spending.
I just want to intercede between Ram and Sapna. Yes. Let us look at the expenses that BBMP needs to incur in the foreseeable future in two parts. One, the maintenance expenses. BBMP is responsible for maintaining the city. The maintenance expenses required for 1 year, and then starting now, whatever backlog has remained undone, a tremendous lot of work has remained undone. So how much will that cost? And then after that, how much will the annual recurring maintenance cost will be? Can I put it this way, Ram? Am I thinking in tune with both of you?
No, I am a learner, so I am okay with any amount of thing, except I want to know, the whole budgeting process seems completely cockeyed. It's not there, but so I'm trying to get the size of the problem we have. And I also, the other question which I want to have Sapna is,
exactly,
where are they getting the money from? Property tax and motor vehicle tax, where is it? Is there any dream? Is it a dream or is it a reality?
No, sure. So to answer the first question, somebody else wants to make a point?
Yes, I wanted to make some points. Gautam Kamath here from Unity
Board. Gautam, can you wait for a minute? Sapna is answering Ram's question.
No, I think it's a related question. Point. Maybe that's where he wants.
Yeah. You have 11,649 crores budget. What is the wages on part of the percentage of wages of the budget? And it's the capital and maintenance, three parts. Yeah. Capital, maintenance, and wages.
The wages are less than 1,000 crores at the last check, which is the last year's budget. I don't have the exact figures for this year's budget, but it's very small given that we have a large, it's like the base of the pyramid, no, in terms of number of employees is really large, but they're not high cost in that sense, right? And the competent people that you want in the system are not there. So the wage bill is not really that high. In terms of where the money is coming in for the BBMP, broadly, the revenues are from property tax. The significant amount of money comes from properties. Related to that is fees and advertisement taxes and all that. But the significant one is actually property tax. The other are grants, state and central level grants. In the last few years, the dependency of the BBMP on state grants has been extremely high. So this year and the previous year, they are between the ranges of 40 to 45% of all the BBMP's revenues are dependent on states. And it's a very unhealthy way, of course, to survive, given that there's no predictability to when state grants are coming in. And as of December, at least the last data that we looked at, even though the state was expected to give close to 4,000 crores to the city this year, the receipts have been less than 1,000 crores. And even the property tax, which was over 3,500 crores of property tax expected to be collected, they have collected less than 3,000 crores of property tax. So in terms of their own revenues, we are not a very buoyant city right now. And therefore, our inability to really, pick up projects at our own timelines, execute, provide quality, and so on. Therefore, always in firefighting mode.
Okay. So the question is, last question from my side. Is if your 40 to 45% is going to come from the state government, obviously the entire setup will be subservient to the state's interests and their machinations. Is there any way the community level fundraising or something? I'm saying it's all small thing. Is there any other way we can refigure this whole thing so that the whole money is spent in the ward itself?
Yeah, so there is a way to do this, right? So one is, we had done an exercise many years ago, but I don't think the outcomes of that will be very different even today. is to assess the potential revenue capabilities in a certain set of areas across the city, right? And focusing on property tax. There was 3x potential at that point in time. I'm pretty certain that BBMP today is not collecting the 100% potential of property tax from all properties across the city. We can see
when you say when you say 3x, that means if they have collected 3000 plus last year, actually the potential is 3 times, that means 9000 crores.
Could be easily 7000 crores, I'm sure, can be collected in Bangalore. Well, the reason I'm saying this is what happens is there is a demand list for the BBMP. They have been slowly working on, their demand list has improved, but we are not in a position today as citizens to know that is every property mapped and coded in the BBMP's database, right? So if you all remember, about a couple of years ago, there was, when they released the budget, they also released a project with ISRO for GIS, cadastral level mapping of properties. And it was a great move because, and I know for a fact that the project was near completion, but none of the data is in the public domain yet, right? But what that gives you is to say that because we have such rampant misuse of, let's say, zoning and building bylaws and so on, you know for a fact, and recently government is even looking at a regularization spree once again to, access more revenue for the city. We know that... at any given point, a 30 by 40 site, if it was paying 2,000 rupees property tax, would easily end up paying 9,000 rupees property tax, depending on its usage. But what is happening? What is happening?
Somebody wants to ask a question. Yeah, but just wait for a minute. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you carry on, Sapna.
Yeah. So what is happening right now? What I'm saying is that if we were to take a step of really maximizing the potential of property tax in the city, right, through self-declaration, through payments, because see what happens is the middle class normally will always pay on time and, seek the rebate and do all of that. There will be a lot of other entities that are not paying property taxes. So while you will invest your time in running behind maybe a Manyata Tech Park for penalties amounting to 250 crores and run to court, every other week, you rather do the other exercise of really putting together your potential, then put a system in place, incentivize your property tax collectors to go and get 100% collection. Just to give you an insight, we in Odisha, we are running what is called the Municipal Premier League. It's currently on. It's gone a little slow because of COVID right now. But the entire state's tax machinery is in competition right now to collect taxes from their citizens. Right, and they're being incentivized with an award which has been announced by the chief minister for them to do this. Now that's healthy competition, right? You want them to go out and ensure that every taxable property is being taxed and taxes are coming in. There is nothing stopping Bangalore from getting into the same mode and doing that same exercise. That will be a game changer for the city. We should then look, because if you're able to do that and you're able to get your credit ratings up, and you're able to clear off your loans and liabilities and all of that, you don't have to depend on the state and the center. Today, our credit ratings are not as high, so we are not in a position to really go and, let's say, issue bonds, public bonds, green bonds, municipal bonds. We're not in a position to do that, right? Pune has actually done that, can you imagine? And not Bangalore.
Oh, that's great. Okay, thanks, Sapna. And
thank you.
Anybody else? Yeah.
Yeah, this is Vijay Rao. I have a question, Subbu. Can I ask?
Sure, sure.
Can I complete? Can I continue?
Yeah, my question is not the answer.
Look, just wait for a minute. Yeah, Gautam, go ahead. Sorry, Vijay.
Yeah. Okay, Sapna, I have I want one clarification. This property tax, you said 3,000 is 3,000 crores or 3,500 has been collected and it can go up to 3x, say around, 6 or 8, 9,000 crores.
Yeah, easily. I mean, 3x was at easily, that point. Yeah, so, but easily a
double. My question, okay, my question is, what is the 100% of property tax? What is the amount? If it is 100%, what is the amount? First question. Second question, where is the khata fees? There is something called as khata in Bangalore, right? So, BBMP definitely issues A khata and B khata. B khata is actually not a proper thing, but still it is happening. And there is some amount collected. Under what head it is collected, one, two, and how much is the amount collected? I hope you got both the questions.
This headline item is available in the budget, but okay. You know, I can tell you that, send you that information.
Please.
So I would request people to ask questions about the process of budget making. The details about the numbers we can go, you know, discuss later.
Okay.
No, but Subbu says we are only looking at the process of budget making, and the numbers are already available elsewhere.
Yeah, so my question, I can send you the link, you can look at it.
So probably my question is more relating to the numbers, so I'm not asking, repeating that now.
Okay, good, thanks.
I have been associated with you right from 2001. Yes, okay.
2001.
Yeah, your tender sure jobs. I mean, hello. Yeah, I mean, excellent design, excellent work, everything. Yeah. My only question is, is the laying out of all the utility lines done in a proper way to ensure that, you know, there will not be any digging for at least 5 years or something like that, or how have you managed it? And what is being done in Koramangala, etc., is now a light version of it, okay?
Yeah.
Tender sure light, and where we fear that it is not going to be done properly, and the laying of the utility lines is not according to any proper protocol. Can you throw some light on all that? Are you participating in that? In which case, do you have a control over it? Is there some assurance that, I mean, today they do the white topping, and when they start, then they have to dig through, you know, this thing, what is it, dense concrete for any kind of repair work? Is it not a bigger problem? Yeah.
Okay, sure. This question is not directly related to the budget process, but if you feel you should answer, you can go ahead.
Yeah, I'll make a quick answer. See, the Tendeshwar Road is done by Jana Urban Space Foundation, headed by Swati Ramanathan, our co-founder. So it's a sister organization of ours. We have drafted the guidelines for Tendeshwar, the entire process, the technical guidelines, and the tendering document. We helped the BBMP do the first set of 9 roads in phase 1, right, which was actually the launch of the Tendeshwar project, after which, over the years, it has been adopted by the state government itself. The Tendeshwar roads that are currently being done are not implemented by Jana Urban Space. They are not overseen by Jana Urban Space or anything like that. So it is being done, some of them, directly by the BBMP and through third-party contractors that they are actually contracting out. So in terms of the design, yes, it is designed in such a way that there is ducting for all utilities on the side of the road, and therefore the roads are not necessarily supposed to be dug up. If they do, it is because of the bad implementation of the guidelines. So I can just stop with that.
Okay.
Thanks.
Thank you, Sapna. Thank you.
Yeah. So any other questions from anybody?
Yeah, Gautam Kamath.
Shrikant, Gautam wants to ask some question.
Yeah, please carry on.
We were talking about the wages. It is around 1,000 crores, maybe 10%. So capital, the budget is done on a capital base, capital expenditure, and one is maintenance. So the capital, I understand, what is the percentage which goes into maintenance? They calculate anything for maintenance, routine maintenance?
Yeah, let me say, I don't have the numbers right now with me, but I can send you, I can maybe send you.
Yeah, Gautam, this information is available in the BBMP website itself. I can send you the link.
No, what I was talking, any process, how do they arrive at maintenance cost for the whole city per year? Is there any?
There is no sanctified 100% process. Okay. It is based on the previous budget. See, I also want to tell you all, every year's budget There is a reason why it is always higher than the previous year's budget, to the extent that the last commissioner had even written a letter to the government asking government to ensure that the BBMP budget does not cross 9,000 crores, right? But we still went and issued 11,000, 600 crore budget, right? That is because we have not been able to achieve actuals on this. So the process of identifying that is not as kosher as, you know, it should be, for example, because there is no trail of all what is going on, like how many assets are there in the BBMP, you know, what are the rentals coming in from assets. There is no dashboard currently that we know of in the public domain that the BBMP is using to assess, you know, what is the daily outflow, right? What is the monthly outflow and how are they planning to spend this 11,600 crore budget quarter on quarter for the entire year? And therefore, we are not in a process to really understand or for me to tell you how they arrive at it. We can surmise on it, but I don't think there is a complete transparent scientific process behind it.
Yeah, so that's the biggest challenge. Even when we talk about budgeting, this will be a biggest challenge because without any backup documents or previous years, without estimations, simply some figures are put, I believe.
Yeah, you're right, Gautam. In fact, if you look at the budget, there are certain things like, you know, what's called as a mayor's discretionary, money. Deputy mayor's discretionary grant. Large sums. How they will be spent, it is anybody's guess.
Yeah, that's what, finally, whoever corporator who has power or this thing, clout, he draws the money to his ward.
Yeah, so I also want to add, for everybody's, input, is that, the budget, the way it is done right now, it's more a political document, right? It is highly also influenced by the MLAs, right? So the MLAs do hold a significant, influence over how the budget is prepared.
Right.
That is because you will never really see budgets being realistic. So even while they say it's a realistic budget, it is not based on any data. For example, if you ask them, why are we changing 5 lakh streetlights to LEDs? Yes, there is an argument that we want to go green and you want to reduce power, all of that, very fair and very, rightful in its intent, right? But how will you go and implement, 270 crore budget over 27 months, I think it has been contracted out to Shapoorji Palonji at the last time I checked. But the fact is, you should look at data should tell you where should you be investing that money first. You should actually be putting it in roads and streets where the lighting levels or the quality is really poor and therefore it is a safety and a risk hazard, right? But there is no point. But we don't do that. I've had lights in my street changed. We had perfectly good lighting before that, right? Overnight, all the lights were changed and we had no idea who came and when it even got done, right? So I'm just saying there is no data that drives even the implementation of this. So you will see this problem all the time because there is no data that is driving how you arrive at the budget. You will always have an ad hoc budget that is being put together and it is political.
Okay, thank you, Sapna. Just one more time for one more question. Srikanth, you can ask that question.
I do have a question.
We do have 15 minutes. Lali seems to have posed a question on the chat window. Why don't we first finish that?
Okay, unfortunately, I'm not able to see the chat window. Can you read out?
Okay. The question from Lali is, budget for roads come under BBMP. Widening of Sarjapur Road is stuck because of the company. What is the percentage of burden on BBMP or is BBMP responsible for this funding?
I'm not sure if the Sarjapur Road widening is a BBMP project, BDA, or is it coming under KRIDL under the state. So, I'm not really in a position to answer that factually.
But probably can you answer in a generic manner, Sapna? Generally, when it comes to road widening, when it comes to new road laying, who's responsible for that?
See, the BBMP is responsible for maintenance of roads in the city. So any road works, there are a couple of categories. So there are major projects. There is a department in the BBMP that looks at, large road projects which cut across multiple wards or are very large flyovers, or road over, bridges and so on. And then there are the arterial, subarterial, local and the collector roads, which also come under the BDMP. So depending, but there are also roads that have been laid in the past in the BDA. There have been roads that, because in Bangalore, you do have some roads that come under, are classified as highways, therefore they go into the state and also get done, right? But not so much right now. So predominantly the road works do come under the BBMP. So the roads, the footpaths, the drains along the footpaths, all the culverts, you know, the street lighting, creating the lampposts, all of that does come under the BBMP itself. They are responsible for it. And it has to come from their budgets.
Okay, thank you. And I had a question, and I think Soumya Raghavan had also posted a question earlier on what is this KMAP is what she said. It's actually KMAB. So I had a question relating to the Karnataka Municipality Accounting and Budget Rules 2006. It's been an act which has been in place since 2006, which effectively can bring some kind of transparency, accountability to the overall finance and accounts of BBMP. And I think I heard you say that all the other cities in Karnataka come under that. The only city that doesn't come under that is Bengaluru. Is there any reason for that? Is there any way people can file a public interest litigation or any case that can be filed to bring BBMP under this?
Absolutely. You can. I mean, anybody is free to file a PIL to bring KMABR, Bangalore under KMABR. I'm not, I mean, I can only surmise and guess as to what the reason for exclusion would have been. One, of course, I know the BBMP, after Prasad's letter had gone to the state government, was working on processes and rules to map, you know, or understand how this could affect the BBMP budget and financial management processes. I don't know at what level that is stuck. But that is something that was in the card. So there was work towards getting BBMP into the KMABR, under the KMABR rules. It is also something that we are, you know, working with the state CAG and all of that to get this under. But yeah, there is, anybody can file a PIL, absolutely. To at least seek information on where it is right now and how soon we can get the city under that.
Okay, thank you for that. Couple of other things I want to quickly bring up and take your views on that as well. One, it's quite ridiculous that the budget for a year is actually being presented tomorrow. That is on April 20th, when we're already 20 days into the year. So obviously it's a shambolic process. It just doesn't make any sense. Then on top of that, you mentioned something else, that at the end of the year, they put out something called as a revised budget estimate for the previous year. Is this a world record where an organization prepares and provides a budget for a year after it's been completed? Do we have any precedence of any other organization or a state or a country doing this? This seems absolutely shambolic.
Yeah, I mean, see, providing a revised estimate is not a bad accounting procedure, right? But ideally, a revised estimate should, ideally it happens in the middle of your financial year, so that by the middle of your financial year, you already have a sense of how you've done so far. You have some visibility onto your cash flows and your ability to execute projects. And therefore, you're able to predict as to how much of money you are expected to spend based on your manpower, execution capabilities, and so on, which are very poor in the BBMP. So the revised estimate by itself is not a wrong thing. The revised estimate being done, you know, at the last minute without really taking in putting out a transparent process of what have you achieved quarter on quarter, you know, what are the reasons as to why we are revising the estimate now? What have been the key facets that, you know, has forced the BBMP to look at a revised estimate? Because it cannot be that, okay, we didn't manage to do this and therefore we'll revise it to wherever we think, you know, it's plausible right now. That's not a done thing that I would agree. But that's how it is. And there is no budget and accounting rules that are governing the city. And therefore, we are not in a position today to hold them completely responsible for this based on process, policy, acts, and so on.
Right. So a follow-on question to that is, Sorry, can I finish this? There was a follow-on question to that. Generally, we've been trying to dig the trail of when the budget is allocated, when it's sanctioned, when the projects against that are executed, and when the audit is done. So based on whatever we've been seeing, is that, let's say, a budget gets allocated in a particular year, I would presume that the reason why they get revised at the end of the year is because very often we are seeing that the projects which are supposed to be executed against that budget actually get executed in the next financial year. The payments happen a couple of financial years after that, and audit happens years after that. So in essence, between the time that the budget is provided to the time the audited accounts are done, there is a lag of about 5 to 6 years. Is that a reasonable understanding?
It's a reasonable understanding to the extent of payments for projects. So, of course, there is no strong audit system that goes on, you know, in the BBMP. So audits do happen, you know, over a couple of years, multiple years and so on. But what because of the legacy of having pending payments to be made, whatever money is there with the BBMP, they do in the beginning of the year, a lot of the payments will be for pending and spillover works. Pending works are works which are over 1 year old, previous 1 year and plus. Spillover works are those that have spilled over from the previous fiscal. So you will see that a lot of money is going into paying these works, right? Which are the pending and spillover works. So the payments for current year's works only if at all there is a good cash flow in the system will happen only in the second half of the year, subject to projects being completed. Therefore, because the BBMP is not always in a good cash flow position for that matter, you will not see, you will always end up having a lot of spillover works. In the last 2 years, they did well by reducing the number of spillover works and pending payments that they have. But they will have to zeroize it at some point so that they have at least less than 10% at any given point that they're carrying over to the next year, which is, I don't think that's the case yet.
That's true. The spillovers and the pending bills are huge amount in the budget.
Can I,
Gautam here, can I ask one question?
Yes, got
it. In terms of tendering, what percentage of tenders go for retendering? Because retendering is where you lose the time for the whole year. I worked on infrastructure projects, and I see that in Hubli Dharwad, I was working for Smart City project. Every tender has gone for three retenders. So the whole project shifts to next financial year.
Absolutely. Yeah. See, I don't have a number today on the number of retendered projects. I had data till December on the number of tenders. They called close to over 5,000 tenders in Q3. But I don't have the number of retendered projects. So I don't know what the percentage of that is.
Vishwanath Rao has been waiting to ask a question.
Regarding D Khata, a small deviation, no doubt. It has been held illegal by the Honorable High Court of Karnataka in December 2015. And it is continuing even now. It was started in 2009. For more than 11 years, it is continuously. D Khata holders are held as second rate citizens. Will it continue like this forever?
Okay, it is not a directly relevant question.
What I'm just saying is that it's a part of another, it's an implementation challenge, you know, like many other things that are there in the city. I don't have an answer to that as to when it will continue or stop.
Okay.
Sapna,
on the chat window on why we have put out the BNP draft manifesto. So Sapna, I'm not sure whether you're able to see the screen. We have put out a document which is a BNP draft manifesto for financial management. It's a draft manifesto, but I think we have already done a lot of background work on that. Subbu is the one who prepared it. We request you to go through it. It would be great if you all can provide inputs on that. It's available on our website as well. effectively, what we are promising to the city at a very broad level is, we will do proper data management through use of systems and technology and bring all properties under revenue collection. Then we are promising that we will work towards fighting for a proper budgeting process, which doesn't keep getting revised again and again. We'll work towards a good accounting system, which is properly correlated with the budgeting process as well. And ultimately, there should be timely preparation of accounts, MS, and audit of DPP, which today is not happening at all. And ultimately, we want to engage proper organizations. And that's where, even today, we are showing the commitment by engaging with people like you to get the proper expert opinion on various topics, so that we'll be able to bring proper procedures to that. And lastly, BNP commits to transparency and engagement with citizens when it comes to budgets, finance, accounts, and audit. That's the reason why we have put out this document on the screen. It'll be great if Sapna, you, your team, Janagraha, and anybody else who's directly related to this can provide your input so that this document can become even more robust.
Sure, we'd be happy to do that. Yeah, we'd be happy to do that. Subbu, if you can just send this across to us, sure. Ideally a Word version, if you can send it to me, we'd be happy to share our thoughts and comments and guidance.
Sure, I will do that. Thank you. We have to now close it, you know. Are there any other questions? Just one more question.
Subbu Muridhar Rao here. I have one question. I have typed it in the thing already. You know, at the meeting about early in January or something like that, Dr. Ashwath Narayan was talking about, you know, preparing a history sheet of all the roads, you know, of all the works done. Is Janagraha involved in it, or do you have any information on that?
We had proposed that we could do this on I Change My City many years ago, Mr. Rao, I think about 4 years ago. I know that the road history project has been in the works for over 5 years, if not more than that. I don't know where it is right now. At any given point, it is just about to be released. So we'll have to just wait and see.
Okay, thanks.
Super, last question, possible?
Yeah.
Is there a multi-party oversight possible on this budget and spends on PBMP?
Well, I suppose it's left to the parties to create those, coalitions to make that happen.
Okay, that's a good question and a good answer.
The entire council is actually just for that. That's all they should be doing. They should be reviewing the budgets on a monthly basis, if not at a shorter frequency.
Okay, looking at the interest this dialogue has generated, my friends in the meeting, I think we can have one or two more meetings on the BBMP budget process. Of course, we don't need Sapna for all this, but we can have discussion based on further facts which we'll gather. And we can go ahead with a very good draft financial management system for BBMP, and we'll have more discussions on this. So now it's really time is up and we have to close. So I would like to thank Sapna for wonderful dialogue we had with you today, and the kind of insight you have given into the budget process of BBMP is excellent. And as Srikanth said, it will be great if you can, give us some recommendation on the manifesto, how it can be further improved. And sure. With that, I would like to thank you once again, and we'll close this meeting. Yeah, thanks everybody.
Thank you everyone. Thank you, and good luck. Good luck to all of you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.